Okay, so today's topic is magnetic moment of revolving electron. Then we'll discuss two topics, desire of magnetic relation and Bohr magneton. Okay, so please write down, this is a very important derivation from this chapter. Okay, so suppose an electron is revolving an atom in a circle of radius r with velocity v. Okay, so let's first find out the magnetic moment. So magnetic moment is basically current into area vector. So I will be equal to Q by T. Q means what is the charge. T is the time taken by charge. So an electron is rotating. So on the place of Q, I'll write E minus. On the place of small t, I'll write T. T is time period of one revolution. Now if you'll see, velocity will be equal to 2 pi r by T. So T will be equal to 2 pi r by V. So on the place of T, I'll put 2 pi r by V. So I will be equal to EV upon 2 pi r, where E is charge of electron. E minus is charge of electron. Now magnetic moment is current into area. So I will be EV upon 2 pi r into area is pi r square, because the radius of this is r only. So the magnetic moment will come out to be E minus into velocity of electron into radius of path divided by 2. Okay, so this is our magnetic moment of revolving electron. Now let's come to angular momentum. So angular momentum is basically mvr. So here the electron is revolving, so mass of electron is me into v into r. Now remember, the formula of L is mvr sine theta, but in this case, since the path is circular, so the angle between r and v is 90 degrees, so sine 90 is 1. Also, if you'll remember Niels Bohr's hypothesis, then angular momentum is integral multiple of h by 2 pi. So L can also be written to be equal to nh upon 2 pi. Okay, so now what we'll do is, the formula for magnetic moment is evr by 2. I'll multiply with mass of electron on both numerator and denominator, and I'll take mvr to be a single quantity into E minus upon 2me. But mvr is basically L. So magnetic moment will be equal to angular momentum into E by 2me. So m will be equal to L into E by 2b, and m by L will be given by, I'll write charge of electron to be minus E upon 2me. So this is called as gyromagnetic ratio, whose SI unit is coulomb divided by kg. So this is gyromagnetic ratio. So what is gyromagnetic ratio? Gyromagnetic ratio is ratio of magnetic moment and angular momentum. Also remember what this negative represents. This negative represents that direction of magnetic moment will be opposite to that of angular momentum. So m will be equal to L into minus E by 2me, where E is charge of electron, me is mass of electron. And what will be the SI unit of gyromagnetic ratio? Coulomb divided by kg. Okay, now what is Bohr magneton? So we have already written that m is equal to minus E by 2me into L, and L is equal to nh by 2 pi, Niels Bohr's hypothesis. So Bohr magneton is magnetic moment of first orbit. So if I'll put n equal to 1 in this formula, and I'll put h upon 2 pi on the place of L, I'll get minus eh upon 4 pi me. So magnetic moment of first orbital is called as Bohr magneton. Please remember this line, that what is Bohr magneton? Magnetic moment of electron in first orbit, it is n equal to 1, ground state, is called as Bohr magneton. Okay, so now what you have to do is, you have to submit a sheet on torque that I am sending it to you with this video. Okay.